In commemoration of the 19th World Day Against Death Penalty, legal practitioners and civil society organizations have called on the federal and state government to review the use of death penalty in Nigeria's laws. The groups, the Legal Defense and Assistance Project and Human Rights Law Service, made the call during the media discussion on the need for the abolition of death penalty in Nigeria. Our correspondent Babajide Lee reports.
The World Day Against the Death Penalty is observed every 10th of October. It unifies the global movement on the abolition of death penalty, with the civil society mobilizing support for the universal abolition of capital punishment. This year's event focuses on women who have been executed, sentenced to death, or have had their death sentences commuted, exonerated, or pardoned. This group is seeking for the abolition of the death penalty.
Right now, our system is inefficient. The gatekeepers of our criminal justice system are corrupt, inefficient, and they don't even have the right resources, you know, to be able to carry out their tasks, which is to investigate and prosecute offenders. And if they don't have all of this, then we are not ripe. We can't say that, you know, we should go ahead and be executing people when we don't even have enough resources to ensure that crimes are contained. I think it's very important we know this. You know, death penalty does not deter crime anyway. I think what actually stops people from committing crime is the fear of apprehension. So if we can improve our criminal justice system, then people will be reluctant to carry out crimes.
If the idea is an eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth, then it should be equal. You know, the poor and the rich should face the same consequence for the offenses that they commit. But that's not what happens in Nigeria. Most times you see that it is poor people that really feel the weight of the law. Rich people get away with it. Our police force is ill-equipped. We still have corruption issues within the police. Our court systems are also a challenge.
In a recent statement by Nigeria's Minister of Interior, Rauf Aregbesola, 3,008 convicted persons are waiting for their date with the executioners in the correctional facilities. The ministers who urged state governors to sign the death warrants of the convicted persons said it is an avenue to decongest prisons and accelerates the wheel of justice. This call was, however, publicly condemned by civil societies, lawyers and international organizations, including Amnesty International.
There's actually a moratorium bill which is currently pending at the National Assembly. In fact, that bill has been there for over 10 years and nothing has been done about it. We actually want the government to pass an official moratorium on execution. There's been this story that we have an unofficial moratorium. But, you know, 4 years ago, or was it 5 years ago, you know, inmates were still executed.
We've been engaged in all different ways, different forms of advocacy to get government to take a second look at the application of death penalty in Nigeria, and we're hopeful that things will turn around very soon.
Advocates are calling for the exploration of more restorative forms of justice aimed at bringing out the good in any convict, as opposed to the death penalty. Babajide Lee, Silver Bird News 24, Lagos.